हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू? होप यू आर ऑल फिट एंड फाइन. माई सेल्फ योर इंग्लिश टीचर गुलशन शरीफ वेलकम्स यू टू महिला समाज ऑनलाइन डिजिटल क्लासेस. सब्जेक्ट इंग्लिश, टॉपिक टोनी द ह्यूमन वेब्स, क्लास फोर्थ स्टैंडर्ड. टोनी द ह्यूमन वेब्स. So before starting the lesson, you have to match the words from column A to the meanings in the column B. So let's go for that one. In the column A, you have the word, and in the column B, you have the meaning. Column A, first one, discriminate. What is the meaning of discriminate? Column B, third one, to treat a person worse or better than another in an unfair way. Harass, to annoy or worry somebody by putting pressure on them or saying or doing unpleasant things to them. Humiliate, to make somebody feel ashamed or stupid and lose the respect of other people. Bystander, a person who sees something that is happening but is not involved. I hope you got the answer. In short, 4, 3, 1, 2 is the answer. Now let's go to the chapter. When the school bell rang, all the students walked out of the gate with a smile on their face, except Tony, who had missed his lunch yet again. As usual, one of the older boys had taken his packed lunch, threatening to give him a good hiding. On his way home, Tony stopped at the park and sat on a bench, trying to cope with his anger. While he was gazing at the plants and flowers, he saw a wasp flying about among the rose bushes. It gave him a bit of a fright. So dear students, here Tony is the name of a boy. So usually he went to school daily, but daily he missed the lunch. Why? Because in the school his friends used to take his lunch and give a good hiding for him. When the school bell rang, all the students, they went out of the gate with a smile on their faces, but except Tony always will have a sad face because he daily miss eating his lunch. As usual, this time also he missed the lunch. So as always, one of his senior boys has taken his lunch box, troubling him and telling him that he would be beaten up while going back home. So they used to threaten this Tony, if he narrate this one to others, they will give the beatings when going back to home. So the Tony, he kept quiet. He used to keep quiet. Tony sat. One day he got very frustrated and he got very angry. So he went to the park. Tony sat in the park bench trying that put up with his anger. While he was staring at the plants and flowers in the park, he saw a wasp. Wasp means insect in the rose bushes. It frightened Tony. What make him to frighten there? Let's study. See? After the bell rang, all the boys coming out from the school gate. Happily they are coming out. So this is a Tony who misses his lunch again. As usual, the boys, older boys has taken his packed lunch box. And Tony to cope with cope up with his anger, he sat on a bench in the park and observing the wasp. So when he was gazing at the plants and flowers, he got an idea. So he saw a wasp flying about among the rose bushes. What happened next? Let's see. He wondered how a tiny wasp of the size of his little fingertip could frighten him like that. That was just what he needed to do himself against the older boys. He spent a while observing the insect. By the time he arrived home, he had a good understanding of the wasp's trick. It was fear of the sting. A wasp could never fight off a person, but everyone was so afraid of its sting that they left the wasp in peace. Tony spent the night wondering what his sting could be. He tried to think out what would frighten those bigger boys. He thought of a plan and smiled. "I will be setting myself free from fear tomorrow," he made up his mind. He thought how tiny Waps was, and the tiny Waps was just little tip of him. It could frighten him like that. It all he had to do to fear the older boys. He spent some time looking at the insect deeply. By the time he reached home, he had understood the trick of the Waps. It was only the fear of stinging. A Waps could never fight with a person. Everyone was afraid of the sting, so they left the Waps in peace. Nobody will trouble the Waps. So Tony spent the whole night thinking about that. What his sting could be, what his plan could be. He tried to think what would feel the older boys. He thought of a plan and started to smile. And he said himself, "I will be setting myself free from the fear tomorrow," he said, and slept. See, he just wondered how a small tiny Waps of the size of the fingertip can make the person free. He was deeply inspecting the Waps, and he happily arrived home. He had a good understanding of that Waps, and he followed the trick of the Waps here. Just all the people have fear of the sting of that Waps. Tony spent the night wondering what his stings could be. So he understood the sting's trick, and he said himself, "From tomorrow, I'll be setting myself from fear." Tony spent the whole night, as I told you, in thinking about the string. So he got a trick, he followed the trick, and he set himself there, "From tomorrow, I'm going to be free from the fear." The next day, Tony seemed like a new boy. No longer did he walk with his gaze on the ground, nor did he look away when people spoke to him. He was confident, ready to face up to anyone. He set his mind on his new role of frightening people, and on his back he carried a bag full of stings. The boy who stole his packed lunch that day ate an extremely hot sausage sandwich. The sausage was so spicy that he ended up crying and coughing. Never again did he want to eat anything belonging to Tony. So sausage means a mixture of finely chopped meat, fat, etc. in a long tube of skin. Okay, so what happened the next day means, the next day Tony looked like a new boy. He did not walk looking at the ground. Usually he used to walk by seeing the ground there. He don't have the practice of seeing here and there. He was very much worried. He was very much worried, and he walked away when people spoke to him. He was have the confident. He was full confident and was ready to face anything and anyone. He has set up his mind in a new idea of frightening the people, and in his bag he carried a bag full of stings. So dear students, sting means a sharp pointed organ of an insect or creature that can go into the skin, leaving a small, painful and sometimes poisonous wound. For example, iga nimge idu anadu jane hula kachidre adontara hullu mullu olagade hogbitti enagutte nimge adu uta barutte, you will get the pain, everything. That is called as a sting here. Okay, so anything, he never wanted to eat anything that belongs to Tony. So the next day Tony was arriving to the school without caring anybody. So the boy who used to steal the box, this day also he took the packed lunch of the Tony, and he had the sausage. It was so spicy that he made up his mind not to have the next time Tony's lunch again. So another boy wanted to hit Tony, but this time Tony didn't run away. From memory, he told him the phone numbers of his parents, his teacher, and the boy's own mother. If you hit me, they will all find out and you will be feeling sorry for what you did. Tony told him, looking at the boy so determinedly and bravely that the boy left him alone. So another boy who always hits Tony, but this time Tony didn't run away from him and his memory, he told the phone number of his parents, his teacher, and the boy's own mother's number also. From the memory, and if you hit me, they will find one at you did and they shall be sorry for that and you will feel sorry for what you did, Tony told him, and looking determinedly, the boy left Tony alone. This tactic worked. He was so happy. So another bully wanted to take Tony's color pencils instead of giving them in fear. Tony gave the boy a small card written by a policeman he knew. It read, "If you rob this boy, I will come after you and I will even lock you up." See, another boy wanted to hit the Tony. The Tony, without fear, he stand in front of the boy and he recalled the phone numbers of his parents and teacher and his own mother also. That boy, after listening to this, he left him alone. See, he was giving the phone number from his memory. Seeing this, the other bully, he went away. So another day, what happened? Just like Tony was afraid of the beatings of the older boys, so the boy, Tony's color pencils, he wanted to take the crony's color pencils instead of giving them in fear. So usually the boys took the color pencils, they never give back the color pencils. So that boy, if he has, means again they will threaten the Tony. So this time the boy want Tony's color pencil. Instead of giving them in fear, Tony gave the boy a small card written by a policeman. He knew that it read, "If you rob this boy, I will come after you and I will even lock you up," was written on the card. The small card he handed over to the bully. By seeing that card, the boy went away. So even this tactic worked. Just like Tony had been afraid of their beatings, those big kids too were afraid of many things. No one occasion a bully hit him a couple of times and Tony had to be brave and carry out his warning. The bully got such a fright that from that day onwards he preferred to protect Tony. So in the end, Tony became like the wasps he would seen. Without even having to sting anyone, he frightened them and ensured that no one would mess with him. So here, tactic means the particular method you use to achieve something. Mess with means to cause trouble for. So just what happened here, Tony was afraid of the beatings of the older boys. Even the older boys were afraid of many things. You usually used to beat the Tony, now they are afraid of the Tony. It so happened that a bully hit him a couple of times and Tony was brave enough to warn him. So now he used to warn the boys, bully that used to beat the Tony. Tony had brave enough to warn him. That bully got so frightened of Tony, from that day he decided to protect Tony instead of bullying him. So in the end, Tony became like the wasps he had seen without even having a sting. Everyone was frightened of him, frightened of Tony, and no one would even mess with him. As I told you, mess with him means nobody caused the trouble for Tony. So dear students, so I hope you understood the lesson here. This lesson was written by Pedro Pablo Saxton. Okay, so this is the moral story for you, that you should not hurt anybody, that is especially your friends. You should be friendly with them. You should your friend in need is a friend indeed. So be friendly with others, don't hurt them. See, Tony had been afraid of their beatings. He sarcastically gave the teacher, mother and police phone numbers there. So on one occasion a bully hit him a couple of times. Now he had become his friend, and in the end Tony became like the wasps. He could see without even having a sting to anyone. He frightened them and he ensured that no one could trouble him. I hope you understood the lesson. Please read the lesson twice and try to answer the questions given in the home assignment. Meanings: wasps, a yellow and black insect that can sting. Give him a hiding to beat him up. Tactic: the particular method you use to achieve something. Mess with to cause trouble. Home assignment: write the matchup words one time neatly in your classwork. Who missed the lunch? When the school bell rang, all the students walk out the gate. Walk out the gate. Write this question. Question answers two times in your homework book and send me in the WhatsApp group. Meet you in the next class with a new chapter. Dear students, from our next class, get ready with the SEM 2 textbook as we are going to start up with the SEM 2 syllabus. Till then, stay home, stay safe, have a good day. Thank you.